Hello everyone, welcome back to another session in Dentistry and More. Today's topic in prosthodontics is compensatory curves. So these are the curves where we keep our artificial teeth so as to achieve a balanced occlusion. So we have three curves basically. One is curve of Spee, curve of Monsoon and curve of Wilson. So ultimately these compensatory curves manages the teeth alignment in such a way that there will not be any dislodgement, there will not be deviation of occlusal forces, so it will be in a harmony, so to achieve a balanced occlusion. So we'll start with the curve of Spee. So it is anatomic curve, that is the curve of Spee. It is anatomic curve established by the occlusal alignment of the teeth as projected onto a median plane. Okay. So it begins from the cusp tip of mandibular canine, then following the buccal cusp tips of the premolars and molars, and continuing with the anterior border of the ramus, and ending with the anterior most portion of the mandibular condyle. Okay, so don't worry about this picture. It's not a perfect picture. So anyway, it's starting from canine, following the buccal cusps of premolars and molars, the anterior border of the ramus, then the anterior most portion of the mandibular condyle. So this should be the teeth arrangement. Okay, so if you are arranging in a curve of Spee, there will not be any much forces which can dislodge the balanced occlusion or dislodge the denture. So we need to arrange in a curve of Spee alignment. So the second one is curve of Wilson. Okay, so it is basically to arrange the molars. So you can see the molars are arranged here. So the lower teeth are inclined lingually. So there is a lingual inclination of lower teeth, and which giving prominence to the buccal cusps and bringing them into a heavy occlusal contact with the upper buccal cusp. Okay, so you can see it is slightly going away, the upper teeth are moving away, and this is converging, this is diverging. So the buccal cusp is going between the cusp, the maxillary molars, so to give a heavy occlusal contact with the upper buccal cusp. Okay, so this is a upper buccal cusp. So when we have lateral movements on working side, we need to give a heavy occlusal contact on the upper buccal cusps. So that is a Wilson compensatory curve. It is basically for the arrangement of molars. And the last one is curve of Monsoon. Curve of Monsoon, the curve of occlusion in which each cusp and incisal edge touches a segment of a surface of an 8-inch sphere. So if we extend this, okay, we extend this like this, it will become an 8-inch sphere. This will be a 4-inch, this is the radius, and this will be the diameter. So it will become a circle of 8-inch. So this is almost like a 4-inch equilateral triangle from the point glabella, and this is a hinge joint, and this is a tip where the both occlusal rim joins. So this is an 8-inch radius circle with a center point at glabella. So it is a concept is such a way that the curve, the occlusion, so the curve of occlusion in which the each cusp and incisal edges touches a segment of a surface of a sphere. So all the cusp tip and incisal edges touches the sphere. Okay, so the sphere means a sphere of 8-inch radius with the center at glabella. So we need to put all these compensatory curve concept when arranging the artificial teeth so as to achieve the balanced occlusion. So it is to achieve balanced occlusion. So hope you understood the concept of compensatory curves. I'll come up with a new topic in prosthodontics. Thank you.